Hello everybody, welcome back to another vlog. Now, this weekend is supposed to be a weekend of back to back market secondhand shopping, but as you would have seen in the beginning of this video, I was ranting because I'm a dumbass and I'm a screwball. First thing, I forgot to bring the lightning jack for the microphone for my phone so that I can vlog properly and with proper sound and audio. So I was able to bring the mic but not the adapter, so I'm using my phone's headphones for this. And then secondly, it turned out that all of the clips that I have been vlogging since this morning was not even recorded. So the clip of me inside the Round She Goes pre-loved fashion market, I have the stamp to prove that I was actually in there, but all the clips were not recorded and they disappeared. And I've also already been to the Smith family store, to Salvo's, and to U-Turn Vintage. Oh, and Knopf's Op Shop. I didn't get anything from U-Turn Vintage, Knopf's Op Shops, or the Smith family store. I was tempted by a mulberry bag, folding bag at the U-Turn Vintage, but the straps and a little bit of the leather of the actual bag were already flaking off. So, and even though it was $10, it was still $10 that I didn't need to spend for a bag that wasn't the right quality. Anyway, at Salvo's, I did end up purchasing, this is an Emporio Armani tote in pure leather, not Armani jeans, which is the cheaper version of the brand, but Emporio Armani, and I'll show you it in a little bit. I'm just a little bit disappointed with myself for not realizing that none of the clips that I had filmed was even recorded. So the back-to-back plan is a fail. However, tomorrow there is the Sydney suitcase rummage happening where the Powerhouse Museum is on the Guts Line. It's between the Powerhouse Museum and the Haymarket. It's quite a windy day today, so I'm hoping that this isn't being too noisy or filled with wind interference, but it's okay. I guess I wasn't able to show you what the Round She Goes fashion market is about, but it's essentially a market inside the town hall. And what's annoying about it is that even though it's indoors, they didn't have the air conditioning on, so it kind of felt like you were inside a sauna, especially when you're trying on clothes. So I think that's why I didn't buy anything, and also I don't really need any more clothes, but also because it's still quite pricey. There was a lady there who was selling some really nice secondhand handbags. One of them very much intrigued me. It was a Balenciaga, and it was tagged as $450, but she was going to give it to me for $300. But then I thought to myself, I don't really need another bag. I'm saying that after I just told you that I purchased an Armani bag. But yeah, so I didn't need another bag, and at $300, I wasn't about to pay for another bag for $300, so I didn't get it. I didn't buy it. There was also, what was it? There was a YSL bag as well that she was selling for, I think, $150, but there was quite a bit of damage to it. So I didn't buy that either. But those two really, and I thought to myself, I don't need another black bag because the Balenciaga bag was black, but also, was I going to use it? Did I really want to buy it because it was a nice bag or because it had the brand Balenciaga on it? So I left without buying anything. And everybody's looking at me for vlogging. Anyway, I'm going to go for now and I'll see you in a little bit. Okay, so to finish off this segment, So this is the Emporio Armani, and you can see that there's a little bit of staining there that I'm fairly sure I can remove. The leather's really good. The size has got this zipper that you can zip up, like I did here on this side, but I probably will wear it unzipped, just because when it's zipped up, it does that. So I'd rather have that open up. And you can see with the hardware, it's got Emporio Armani. There we go. Armani on one side, Emporio on the other. This was tagged as $35 on the 21st of October. That price is already good, and you can see when you go inside, it's got Emporio Armani on it. The lining has got Emporio Armani on it. Inside the pocket has got the serial number. It's made in Bulgaria. Okay, so I knew that this was a real Emporio Armani bag, but the thing that was wrong with about it was, one, it's got some like stains on the inside pockets, and two, the corners, two corners of the lining are ripped. Okay, the other side is the same thing, it's ripped, but this is something that I could fix by sewing it up and stitching it up, so I'm not really that bothered by it. The leather is still quite nice and perfect condition. So they actually charged me $15 instead of $35 for this beautiful Armani bag. So I couldn't say no. I didn't have this color in my collection just yet. I was looking for a blue bag, but I didn't get a blue bag. That's fine. I'm probably gonna try and clean up the lining of this Armani and then stitch it up. All right, I'll see you guys tomorrow for the Sydney suitcase rummage. Happy Sunday, everybody. So we are on day two of our weekend vlog, and I am walking towards the Sydney suitcase rummage that's happening at the goods line here at near the Powerhouse Museum. So yeah, I don't really know what else to say, but I'll take you there. I think I've shown you guys this before, because it's where I got my Tory Burch bag before. So we're gonna go there, and I'm just really walking because it's pretty close to where I live. It's about two blocks away. So because yesterday's vlog was such a fail and none of my clips were actually recorded, this time around I've actually started checking whether the clips are being recorded. So I was actually wrong. It's not two blocks away, it's three blocks away from where I live. So let's get to it. So here we are at the goods line. You can see it right there. It's in between the Haymarket or Paddy's Market and the Powerhouse Museum, very close to where Urbanest is. So if you walk further down, it's a whole array of stalls and sellers, literally just suitcases filled with stuff that they are selling. Ranges from clothing to shoes to accessories, and anything and everything in between, really. So okay, so it extends up to the end of the goods line over here where you see the UTS Business School, and yeah, here about here is, like, behind this building is the Haymarket, Paddy's Market. So there's a lot of goods that they're selling, clothes, shoes, bags, accessories. There's one lady, I believe she's Chinese, who's selling a few pre-loved bags. There's some that are interesting, but not enough to get me excited. There was a bucket bag, I think it's from Zara. They're selling for $10. I wasn't sure if I wanted to get one, and because it was cute, but I don't know how often I'm going to use it, especially with pocket bags being so off open that I don't know if it's worth having around. Because you could easily lose a lot of things when you are wearing a bag that doesn't have a zip or any kind of closure. And this one's not, this is a bucket bag that's like quite rounded in the opening, so anybody's hand can just go in there. But it was really cute and I'm really tempted by it, but I don't need another bag. And like I said, I'm looking for a blue bag, not a brown bag. She did have a vintage Celine, but it was more of a sort of like a brief with a pochette inside. There was also a candy bag that's sort of like a satchel that I might be interested in, but I don't know yet. I think I might hold off on buying anything until much later, because with these things, it's actually quite good to come a little bit later in the afternoon, especially if you're not looking for anything in particular, because they would be dropping their prices closer to when it's about to close, so that they could get rid of the stuff and not have to haul them back home. So I think I might wait until later to get that, even if like I don't even know if I actually want to get it. So we will see. Okay, so I took a closer look at the jelly bag that was at the goods lines. They were selling it for $30, and it turns out that it is a Furla bag. And this is what it looks like. It's really cute. Perfect for, well, this summer. Now, this has got a padlock, but I'm assuming they don't have the keys anymore because it's been left locked in there. Inside you got, yeah, there are no pockets inside, but that's fine because most of the time I carry a bag organizer, like here in my Louis Vuitton. I think when I put this into the vlog, I said embrayante because I didn't know how to pronounce it. It's actually embrayante. Okay, so this is the Louis Vuitton monogram Empreint Métisse, yes, hobo version. I took off the smaller strap and just have the long strap with it, and I carry it as a shoulder bag. But that's not what we're here for. We're here for this little candy bag from Furla. I really like it. I think it's gonna serve me well. There aren't any damages to it, not that I can see anyway. Yes, and I'm thinking about how I can actually, I could probably just, oh, okay, so it doesn't actually need a lock, you just pull it. So if I have it closed like so, I can put the lock on. And just lock it like that. No keys needed. There you go. It's got that made in Italy. And I believe, okay. I'm gonna put this in the lock. Because I think I saw, no, that was just my imagination. I thought I saw serial number, but I'm fairly sure this is real. But she's had it for a while. Okay, very happy with this little blue purchase. I think my collection is now complete. I've got a yellow, a blue, a green. I've got a red coming tomorrow, and that's the Chloe bag. Also, for the Philos here in Sydney, there's already a Ray Jr. here at Darling Square. If you go straight from Chinatown or also from Urbanest here, it's just on this alley right here. And here's a little bit on the menu. They've got rice bowls, and I actually ordered the sisig one for takeaway. Okay, so I am finally home. It is so warm outside. My pits are sweaty because, you know, I don't use antiperspirant. I just use deodorizer. Anyway, here is that blue Furla bag that I got, and I just wanted to show you before I ended this vlog. that whenever I carry a bag that is larger, okay, medium to large, I always have this organizer inside. And this is just a regular organizer that I got from eBay. I think I paid $3 for it. It's like a felt material. It's got everything, pretty much everything that I need. I always have an emergency sanitary pad on there. Still trying to convince myself to use the menstrual cup so that I'm more sustainable. Until I am able to, I've got a sanitary pad in there for emergency purposes. The iPhone microphone that you saw me wearing earlier today, and pretty much everything else is organized inside here. Now I want to see if this is going to fit into this jelly bag. I'm just a little annoyed with the opening because it's very limited, so I'm gonna have to shove this in there to make it work. But I'm hoping it fits, so that because this jelly bag doesn't have any pockets, and I want to be able to organize my stuff inside, and it fits. Just need to sort that out. Yep, it fits well. This also fits with my other bags. I think, does it fit my Alma bag? I'm not sure, but it definitely fits this one on here, so I'm happy with that. There is still space like on the side if I wanted to put other stuff in there. And it's definitely gonna fit my umbrella, which I normally carry, especially during the rainy season. So there we go. Okay, loving this $30 furlough bag that I got over at the Sydney suitcase rummage. Okay, I am so oily as well. I'm gonna remove my makeup, probably gonna sit in the bath for a while because it's so warm, to cool myself down, and gonna have my CC rice bowl from Ray Jr. This is not sponsored. Alright, thanks very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this little vlog of ours, weekend vlog. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comment section down below. If you have any questions about life here in Sydney or things that you want me to talk about with regard to moving to Australia, what it's like being a foreigner in this country. Yeah, all that jazz. Let me know in the comment section down below, and I'd be more than happy to help you with that. See you all again in the next video, okay? Bye!